Dear students, today we will see Gibbs-Duhem equation. Now, consider a system containing number of constituents, suppose n1, n2, n3, up to so on, ni. Suppose there is a system containing 5 constituents or 6 constituents. So, we will consider a general ni number of constituents are there. Then, we know that the Gibbs free energy is a function of temperature, pressure and number of constituents. Yesterday we have discussed it. Now if there is any change in any of these one, there will be change in G. And these are the number of constituents. Therefore total of all these constituents will be capital N, that is total number of moles. Now if there is a small change in the constituent, then we will differentiate this G, so you will get dG, and differentiate G with respect to each term now. So dG will be equal to delta G upon del T at constant pressure N1, N2 and so on, you can write here at Ni, into dT. As we are differentiating with respect to T, there will not be T over here. So first term of differential will be del G upon del T at constant pressure N1, N2 up to so on Ni into dT plus, now we will differentiate with the second term, that is P. So del G upon del P at constant temperature, pressure will not be there, temperature N1, N2 and so on Ni into dP. Plus, now differentiate with third term, del G upon del N1 at constant temperature, pressure, N2, N3 and so on into dNi plus and so on, these terms will be there, N2, N3, all terms will be in between. And finally, del G upon del Ni at constant T, P, N1, N2 up to so on N-1i into dNi. So this will be the differential of this G. But at constant temperature and pressure, what will happen? dT will be equal to 0 as temperature is constant, and dP will also be equal to 0 as pressure is constant. Therefore, these two terms will be 0 as it is multiplied by dT. Therefore, this term will be 0. This term also will be 0. So you will get dG at constant TP will be equal to, now, yesterday we have seen that this term del G upon del N1 at constant TP N1 N2 can be written as mu 1, that is chemical potential. So we can replace this term by mu 1. So it will be mu 1 into dN1. Here it should be N1. So mu 1 into dN1 plus there will be mu 2 into dN2 plus and so on. And finally, it will be mu I into dNi. We will denote it by equation number 1. So you will get the term dG at constant TP will be equal to mu 1 dN1 plus mu 2 dN2 plus mu 3 dN3 and so on mu I dNi. But at definite composition, we have to integrate this equation. So what will be the integral of dG? That will be G. So integral of dG will be G at constant TP and N. N is the total number of moles, that is after integration. You will get, what will be the integral of dN1? It will be N1. It is derivative of N1. So integral of derivative will again be N1. So N1 into mu 1. Integral of this will be N2 into mu 2. Plus N3 into mu 3 and so on, plus there will be Ni into mu I. Now if we differentiate this equation, you will get differential of G will be dG. So dG at constant TP, of course, equal to N1 d mu 1 plus mu 1 dn 1. It is a product of n 1 mu 1. What is the differential of product? Suppose we have to differentiate x into y. So it will be x dy plus y dx. Therefore it will be n 1 d mu 1 plus mu 1 dn 1. What will be the differential of this? It will be n 2 d mu 2 plus mu 2 dn 2. Plus and so on, you will get other terms. Now we will separate the terms like this one. N1 d mu 1, this term, see here, n1 d mu 1 plus n2 d mu 2 plus ni d mu I, means we are separating the term of n1, n2 and so on. Similarly, we will separate term of mu 1. So another, in another bracket I can write mu 1 dn1 plus mu 2 dn2 plus and so on mu I dni. So we have separated these terms in two brackets. We have done nothing else, just this is a separation. Means this is the first term, this is second term, third term will be there. Only separation of the terms we have done. Now see here, we can denote it by equation number 2. Now from equation number 1, what is the value of mu 1 dn 1, mu 2 dn 2? This is mu 1 dn 1, mu 2 dn 2, mu I dn I. So this is nothing but dg. So this term is dg. We can substitute it by dg. Therefore dg equal to something plus dg. Means what will be the value of this term? Think over it. See, what is happening? This term is dg. This complete term is dg. This is dg. Means, suppose 5 equal to something plus 5. Means what is this term? It will be 0. 5 equal to 0 plus 5. So dg equal to 0 plus dg. Because this and this term is exactly identical. Therefore, this will be substituted by dg. Therefore, this term must be 0. And as this term must be 0, you can write, see here, n1 d mu 1 plus n2 d mu 2 plus and so on, ni d mu I equal to 0. And if you write it like this, sigma, that is summation of all terms, sigma ni d mu I equal to 0. This is the Gibbs-Duhem equation, which tells us that no single constituent's chemical potential is independent. Means it will depend on the composition of other constituents as well. So this is called as the Gibbs-Duhem equation. This is based on the chemical potential.